Why haven't you played Boogerman yet? Seriously, why not? Yeah, I'm looking at you, sitting there, watching this video. Honestly, the only reason I'm talking about this game is because I'm a little sick right now and I thought, hey, Boogerman! That was a thing! Created by Fallout and Clay Fighter developers Interplay Entertainment for the Sega Genesis and Super Nintendo, Boogerman, a pick-and-flick adventure, is one of those retro games that I don't think I've ever heard anyone say anything good about. In Boogerman, you play as eccentric millionaire Snotty Ragsdale, who has taken a post as a janitor at some laboratory or some shit, which has opened a portal to another dimension! He's the hero that we deserve, not the one we asked for. After some science-y shit gets pulled through this portal, Snotty transforms into his alter ego, Boogerman, in order to stop the perpetrator and save the world. On the surface, this might just look like your standard run-of-the-mill 16-bit mascot platformer with a crude humor aesthetic, but digging a little deeper reveals a game that probably doesn't deserve all the hate that's been piled upon it over the years. Now, I'm not going to sit here and tell you that Boogerman, a pick-and-flick adventure, is some underrated hidden gem or something like that, but I am going to tell you that Boogerman, a pick-and-flick adventure, is a hidden gem that's very underrated. This is one of those games that's often mentioned in retro gaming circles with a heaping side of salt. That is, it's a game that seemingly everyone rented back in the day, and it somehow managed to ruin their whole weekend, or killed their cat, or left toast crumbs in the butter dish, or something like that. And I've always thought this kind of reaction to a game that, in truth, is slightly above average when compared to other games of the era, is a little unwarranted. To begin with, let's talk about the animations found in this game, as they're pretty much the star of the show. As you move about, Boogerman will run, prance, melt, slide, fart, and throw boogers at his enemies, and all of this is animated to such a high degree that you'd swear the animators were veterans of the animation industry. Oh wait, they were! Holy Jesus! Among these veteran animators are Gabby Payne, known for Conan the Destroyer and the Real Ghostbusters, Norlin Talay, known for the Powerpuff Girls movie Quest for Camelot, and Osmosis Jones, and Brenda Banks, who worked on both The Simpsons and King of the Hill, as well as the animated Lord of the Rings movie. And here you thought this game about a booger-throwing superhero didn't have any prestige. You were wrong. Another thing that Boogerman has going for it is its catchy music. Well, at least the Genesis version had this going for it, because the SNES version, well, just listen. So yeah, the Super Nintendo version kinda sounds like a bunch of farts squeezed through a McDonald's-sized bottle of Dasani, but the Genesis version sounds amazing, and you should know by now that the Genesis version is always the better version anyway, so yeah. Genesis. Of course, having fluid animations and great music in your game doesn't automatically mean that it'll be good, especially since this was the heyday of the cinematic platformer, with games like Another World, Prince of Persia, and Blackthorn showcasing some pretty phenomenal animations alongside some of the stiffest and least intuitive control schemes of the era. But here comes Boogerman, yes that one, with fluid animations and decent controls. While controlling our mucusy martyr here, you'll be able to attack by flicking boogies at or belching upon the faces of your enemies, who are promptly dispatched with a satisfying Likewise, hitting down on the D-pad and holding the burp button will charge up a blast of fart energy, which you can release to deal even more damage and break certain rocks, which hide hidden paths and secret items. And then there are a couple of items that make these bodily functions even more potent, such as milk, which turns your boogies into loogies, which do double damage, and peppers that allow you to do, well, this. Cool. Admittedly, the controls aren't as good as they could have been, but they're better than most games of the era, and for a title that's only trying to provide you with a couple hours of booger-throwing fun, I think they get the job done while being further reinforced by the simplistic level design. Though, to be honest, Boogerman's level design and overall structure might be a bit too simplistic for its own good. Each level is a primarily linear jaunt from start to finish, with only minor changes in route along the way, and all of them, save for one, follows a very predictable pattern of four acts and a boss. Yep, you heard me right. Each level has four separate acts that all feature the same enemies, same backgrounds, same environmental design, and the same assets and music. Overall, there are only five levels in the game: Flatulent Swamps, The Pits, Boogerville, Mucus Mountain / Nasal Caverns, and Pus Palace, yet because of this 4 acts per level rule, the total number is actually more like 20, with each level long overstaying its welcome around the end of the second act. And if you've ever wondered why Sonic Team stopped doing 3 acts per level after Sonic 1, for the most part, this would be why. Turns out, players catch on pretty quickly to corner-cutting, recycled ideas, and repeated level assets, which in turn harms the overall pacing and enjoyment of a game. Huh. Who'da thunk it? In truth, Boogerman probably would have been all the better if they had just cut half the levels and spent the development time just making one more completely different stage. The aforementioned levels Mucus Mountain and Nasal Caverns sorta got it right by having only two acts apiece, but they alternate one after the other for a total of four acts, and in my opinion, this is how the whole game should have been structured. For example, instead of going through a variation of flatulent swamps four times in a row, why not do it once and then have the player go to a different but somewhat similar level, like, I don't know, a hidden grove of animal butts or something like that, before going back to flatulent swamps and then back to the animal butts before fighting a boss. Wouldn't that be a lot more interesting? I think so. But of course, that would require the creation of new game assets and extra work and a bigger budget, so yeah. And then of course there are the bosses, who are, well, they're there. Boy oh boy are they there. Now, to be fair, the bosses here aren't terrible. They're just really bad. They certainly look alright, and I can absolutely appreciate the spectacle of fighting them, especially since many of the game's best animations are found during these fights, but their AI is some of the most predictable that I have ever seen. With only a few exceptions, these guys will attack you the exact same way every single time you fight them. And much like the levels themselves, these fights completely overstay their welcome, with the bosses taking hit after hit with no indication of how close you are to beating them. Furthermore, their hit detection isn't always the best either, so they tend to get a lot of cheap shots in on our snotty savior here, making each battle feel like an inclusion simply because video games, rather than because the developers had any ideas for interesting boss encounters. So after all that, you're probably wondering why I called Boogerman a pick and flick adventure and underrated gem just a few moments ago. After all, if the levels aren't really anything special and the combat's pretty lackluster, why do I have such an affinity for this game? Is it simply a case of nostalgia? Yeah, that's probably a big factor, but I think there's more to it than that. You see, I was probably 6 or 7 when I first played this game, and two of my favorite shows at the time were Ren and Stimpy and Rocko's Modern Life, two shows known for their abundance of crude humor, so Boogerman entered my life at just the right time for me to enjoy it properly. I used to rent this game all the time, and when the rental store I got it from went out of business, I actually bought it from them with either some birthday or Christmas money I had, making this cartridge right here the very first thing I ever purchased for myself. Money well spent. I absolutely loved this game as a kid, and I still have a fondness for it to this very day, even though I'm now able to see how flawed it really is. But beyond that, I just don't think this game is as bad as everyone else seems to think it is. I've played a lot of retro games over the years, and maybe it's just the nostalgia talking, but to me, Boogerman's gameplay is pretty much par for the course, downright average for its time. Nothing about it is particularly bad, and it even has a few things that make it quite exceptional for its time, like the aforementioned animation and music. Also, I think it's important to remember who the target demographic for this game was. It was aiming for a lowbrow audience of little kids and adults who enjoy gross-out humor and wacky spectacle, which is something the game definitely provides. It wasn't trying to be the next Sonic the Hedgehog or Mario Jumpman Mario, yet a lot of people seem to treat it as though it was a failed attempt at being the next big thing. But it wasn't. It was trying to be a schlocky B-game for a very specific audience, which is exactly what it ended up being. And I think that's the biggest reason for the dismay brought upon this game, that it's immature. Therefore, as a well-adjusted and tax-paying adult, or rebellious and edgy teenager, I can't possibly admit that I like it because I'm over that kiddie stuff, man. I enjoy long walks on the beach and games made by David Cage. My palate is ultra refined. Well, I'm here to tell you that you're all full of shit. Crude humor rocks and it's fun to be immature from time to time. Boogers are funny, farts are funny, whatever the hell this is funny, and Boogerman's fucking awesome. And you should check it out, if for no other reason than to stick it to the hoity-toity gamers of the world who think that all video games are destined to be as pretentious high art and interactive Sundance films. Sometimes you just need to laugh at a fart. Sometimes you just need to flick a booger. At the end of the day, Boogerman, a pick-and-flick adventure, may not be the greatest hidden gem out there, but it's much better than you'd expect. So if you're looking for something, different to add to your Genesis collection, or Super Nintendo if you must, maybe give it a shot. It may not be the cat's pajamas, but it just might be the toilet bowl from heaven. Or something. I don't know.